Hello my friend and welcome to my channel. Today I've got Glam Polish Harry Potter House Collection. And I'm going to swatch them and do some nail art. Here's the first one. It's Ravenclaw. And the second is Slytherin. And the yellow is Hufflepuff. And the red is Gryffindor. So I'm just going to go ahead and begin with this manicure. I did start off with the Peel Ease as my base coat. And this actually, considering how full of glittery goodness, had a really good formula. Very easy to control. Didn't stop me from making a mess, but it is very easy to control. I love these colors. So I started off with the blue, and then I'm going to do the green. And I do, you know, I'm doing one of each on my four fingers. And then I'm going to put the favorite one on my thumb. And this is a rather long video, so you might want to pause and, you know, go fix a snack. I've just gone, you know, crazy with it. But it's because I end up doing so many steps. This yellow just really, really sang to me. It's my favorite, I think, out of the collection. I had to have these. You guys know, not only am I a polish junkie, but I'm also a Harry Potter junkie, so had to have them. And there's Woody. Woody will probably get quite a workout today. The red's gorgeous too. I mean, they're all really gorgeous, but for some reason, I don't know if it's because it's summer and I was digging the yellow because it's, you know, summer or what, but, you know, I like it. And we're going to go in with the second coat of Ravenclaw. And I'm capping my tips on both coats. Sometimes with jelly polishes I do that. And our second coat of Slytherin. I'm really, really happy with these though. I'm so glad I got them. And I could not wait to use them. Look how pretty that yellow is. I'm telling you, I'm just... I'm in love with it. The yellow one is definitely my favorite. I don't know what it is about it, but it got me. There we go. And I've decided I wanted to go in with a third coat, which normally I don't do. I'm normally a two-coat person, but I just wanted to see if that, you know, third coat would make a difference. And it did a little bit, but, you know, I think if I wear these again, I might wear a similar color underneath and just do one or two layers of the Glam polishes. We shall see. They're so glittery, my camera's having trouble. I'm gonna back it up and see if that'll make it behave. Nope. It's just, there's too many things to focus on. Too many glimmers and shimmers. Okay, now I'm gonna top this off with that Pro FX Quick Dry Top Coat and get it to dry down because I'm gonna do some stamping today. I'm definitely gonna do some stamping. So you can see I got my thumb was yellow also. I'll be using this BBF plate. And if I can find a link for those, I will link them. I'm using a bunch of stampers. Funky Fingers Gesso. And I was going to use Funky Fingers Dark Knight. We'll see. Nope, I'm changing it to Nicole Diary. NSO2. If I can find a link for that BBF plate, I will definitely link it below. So I'm stamping out the house coat of arms for each of the houses for Ravenclaw, Slytherin, Hufflepuff, and Gryffindor. And I'm going to be doing some, you know, some reverse stamping here today. And these are tiny images, but when you go to put them on your nails, they just look so big on your nails. Ah, it's so funny. Now, I do have a little bit of trouble with, I think this one right here. I might not show it, but I did have to restamp that one a couple of times. There we go. I did show it. Ha ha. I did share with the class. I knew this was going to be a long video, so I did try to edit out anything that was just eating up space. So I am going to be filling this in with the white, the Funky Fingers white. It's a nice opaque white polish, and I didn't want to have to do more than one layer. I just wanted to go in and do it and be done. And I'm just using a little end of a dotting tool for this. One day I might get good and start being able to use, you know, like a nail art brush. But today I'm still sticking to my little dotting tool. Love using these clear stampers for this because you can, you know, always look and see, you know, if you missed anything. Might have to add some more of that polish to my mat. Dun, 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 dun. Almost there, folks. We've almost got this one done. I like to flip them over and check, and I can see one spot. I've just got to figure out how to find it on the other side. And just fill that in. And check it. It's kind of hard to see on the camera, but it does work out. I'm also going to be using these Hee Hee plates, number 25, 26, 27, and 28. These are all Harry Potter plates, and they've just got, like, patterns to match those houses. I'll be using the Nicole Diary gold and silver to stamp this part with, and this big old clear stamper from AliExpress, and my Beauty Big Bang scraper. But I just wanted to put some texture behind, you know, the coat of arms for all the houses. And I'm just totally mixing it up today. I'm just... gold, silver, black, white. Let's just go crazy on top of these colors is, I guess, what I was thinking. And it might have been too much having the backgrounds to them. But, you know, I was having to wait on decals to dry. So, that's my excuse. I needed something to keep me busy while those decals were drying. I do end up really liking the manicure, even though it is a little overboard. But, you know, I'm just like that. I do go a little overboard sometimes. A lot of times. I'm going to use the Bundle Monster Smear Free and then the Pro FX on top of these. And then the sticky base coat to get my decals to stick. Because I don't want no mishaps with all the work that's gone into these. Excuse me. I do really like this sticky base coat because, you know, you can paint them and leave them for just a little bit and they're not going to just be dry. They've still got that sticky adhesion and that's good stuff. Okay, so here we go. We're going to start plopping these on here. And I don't line them up so great. I do get them on the nails, but that one went a little bit to one side. Practice will get me there. One day I will get them always perfect, you know. You just gotta keep trying. I think I did pretty good on Slytherin and Hufflepuff, but the pinky and the pointer finger's just a little off. And I'm going to top them with some Poshe top coat to seal them in. But I really had fun playing with this manicure. And to me, I think that's a big, huge part of it. It's, I mean, you do want to end up with a manicure that's pretty and nice and that you like. But you also want to end up with a manicure that you had fun doing. And I had a lot of fun doing this one. So I'm going to do this Harry Potter image on my thumb. Over that yellow. I'm going to do it in white and then in black. just to, you know, kind of bring it into the party with the rest of the nails. Trying to line that up. It's a little tricky. But there we go, I did it. Ta-da! So here's my final manicure. I hope you enjoyed this one. Leave me a comment down below. Thanks for watching. Until next time, be good to yourself. Talk to you soon.